It's kind of ironic that dysfunction teaches us about brain function. Essentially, knocking that area out informs us of why that area is important. And it is stroke. And similar to brain trauma is that stroke is becoming an increasingly big problem, especially in an aging population. Hundreds of thousands of it happen per year. It's one of the most common causes of death in the elderly. And so the brain, you're getting a sense, does a lot of work. And it only weighs a few pounds, but it takes up around 20% of the blood that's coming out of our heart. It requires an immense amount of energy to do what it does. And so when a vessel gets occluded, very rapidly, that area of brain is going to die. Now, again, when we see those strokes, they can tell us some fundamental lessons about how the brain works.
Actually, what exactly do you mean when the vessel gets occluded? What clogs up these arteries?
Yeah, that's a great question. So oftentimes, it's atherosclerosis. Similar to when you have a heart attack, a plaque has formed in the vessel, just like it forms in your heart, and oftentimes it ruptures, and then a clot forms inside that vessel and occludes the blood flow. And so that's why things like clot busters are very useful for preventing a brain injury by getting there quickly. So what are some of those fundamental lessons that stroke has taught us? Well, if you have a stroke, there's four main vessels that go up to your brain. And if one of those goes out, that you can have a stroke that usually affects one side of your brain. And now, if one side of your brain is injured, that usually means that the opposite side of your body is going to be affected. So if I had a stroke in the right side of my brain, very often my left hand would be paralyzed. And it's this notion of lateralization. And again, the brain subspecializes its function by crossing a lot of things over.